Right, folks, bought this Dell monitor, the Dell 2009 WT, and it doesn't appear to turn on. And I did get it to turn on momentarily when I whacked it, so I thought I'd open it up, and I found on the power supply there's this Q101, which has a joint not soldered. So I'm going to try turning it on and just try pressing on that joint and see if we get any action. And if it does work, then I'll just solder it in and should be fine. Right, so on closer examination, there's actually two. There's the Q101 there, and there's also another one Q1083, which is there. 1803, and that one is the problem one, where when I tap it while the monitor is on, it will switch it off and on as I open and close that joint. So so I'll just resolder those two and should be fixed. This board is all waved. They've used the lead-free process on this, and use surface mount, waved surface mount, so they've placed it with glue in the center of each component, and then wave soldered the whole bottom. And as a result, some of these parts weren't soldered correctly. It does sort of trouble me that this got through, but also they haven't used like a hassle finish on the board. It seems to be just copper, so they've really cheapened out on the board, which is typical Chinese fashion. If you're going to go lead free, you should use silver or gold finish, but they've just gone with copper, and as a result you get these defects, which weren't picked up, because it did work for a time and then it didn't, which is why it was so cheap, I guess. The price I paid was about $79, including shipping. There's a lesson to be learned there. Certainly get what you pay for. Anyway, better than paying $200 to $400 for a new monitor. Fix the ones which you can and use them till they blow, basically. Till the backlight blows. Then you could replace the panel, but you might as well just replace the whole screen. Yeah.